Hey guys, welcome back to Math Hacks. I'm Brett, and today on Math Hacks, I am showing you how to add and subtract radicals together. I have a few examples for you. Some involve square roots, and some involve cube roots, but all of them involve simplifying radicals before you can add and subtract them. Now, what's important to remember is that we cannot add and subtract square roots or cube roots or any type of roots if the number underneath the root is not the same and if the type of root is not the same. So they both, in this case, they both need to be square roots, and we need to simplify these so that both the number under this root and under this root are the same. Let's start by pulling out any perfect squares that are factors. Now I'm going to choose to just break those into two separate roots on each of these. That just makes it a little more obvious what is going on when we want to simplify. Now we can see that the square root of 4 is 2, so this is the same as 2 square root 2. And the square root of 25 is 5, so I have 5 square root 2. So conveniently this worked out so that we have, in both of these terms, we have roots of 2, square roots of 2. So I can go ahead and combine these. Now when I have 2 square root 2s plus 5 square root 2s, that'll make 7 square root 2s. So with this problem, the factors are not as obvious. And whenever I have factors that aren't obvious, I like to do factor trees to simplify them. So I'm going to make two factor trees over here on the side in my scratch work. So let's go ahead and write the prime factorizations for both of these. I have 7 squared times 5 here, and 5 squared, 5 cubed here, 3 of them. Let's replace our large numbers with these little more manageable numbers to work with. Because I'm working with square roots, I'm gonna go ahead and split these apart. And this one, instead of just having 5 cubed here, I'm gonna take 2 of those 5s together here and then leave the third 5 by itself in another square root. This just makes it easy, the easiest way to take square roots. Here we have 7 square root 5s, and we're subtracting away 5 square root 5s, which leaves us with 2 square root 5s. Now that we're working with cube roots, we want to find perfect cube factors. Again, I'm not really seeing right away what the cube root factor of 108 might be. So for that one, I'm going to go ahead and make a factor tree just like we did before. So our prime factorization for 108 is 3 cubed and 2 squared. Okay. Much easier numbers to work with. I'm going to go over here and replace 108 with those numbers. So 3 cubed times 2 squared. 8 times 4 is 32, and I know that 8 is a perfect cube. So instead of going through the work of making a factor tree, I'm just going to skip straight to that part. So I'm going to break this into 8 times 4. Now, since I'm working with cube roots, I'm going to go ahead and split apart the factors at convenient places. Now, the cube root of 3 cubed is 3. I can't simplify this one, so I'm just going to go ahead and multiply 2 squared back to make 4. And then over here, I know that 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. So the cube root of 8 is going to be 2. And I can't simplify the cube root of 4 any further. All right, so now we have the conditions that we need We have cube roots on both of these, and both with bases of 4. So 3 cube root 4 minus 2 cube root 4s makes 1 cube root 4. I don't need to write the 1 down. I can just write cube root of 4 as our answer.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to grab your free printable in the description box below. And while you're there, give me a big thumbs up and hit that subscribe button so that you get more math hacks in your feed. Until next time, I'm Brett Berry, and good luck with all that math.